Hi, I'm Sanjay Choudhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to use Designer in IBM App Connect Enterprise version 13. So users of previous versions of App Connect Enterprise will be familiar with a toolkit. The toolkit is generally aimed at integration experts who need to create flows which process a variety of message formats across many different transport protocols. It is a powerful IDE which allows you to develop and test message flows and message models so that you can create an integration solution. Designer has been available in the IBM App Connect Enterprise as a service offering for a few years now. Designer allows you to build flows that require low code and can access SaaS endpoints using event-driven flows or using a REST API. The flows in Designer are completely schema-driven and can connect with hundreds of applications on cloud and on-premise through pre-built smart connectors. Designer is predominantly aimed at business technologists who want to rapidly assemble integrations with low-code and using high-productivity tools. So Designer has been provided in App Connect Enterprise version 13 now. And in this demo, I'm going to show how to create a simple Designer flow from scratch. I'm going to use a GitHub node to access some issues from a GitHub repo. And for each issue that is found, I'm going to send a Slack message to a channel. So I'll create this flow step by step so that you can follow along. So after installing App Connect Enterprise version 13, you will see the usual menu options for launching the toolkit and for starting a command console. But new in version 13, there is a third option now to start Designer. So you can select the option to start Designer. And when you do that, it will actually start the Designer process in the background. So this allows you to create your Designer flows and then test them. So when you start Designer, you will see the welcome page and you are presented with options to either create an event-driven flow or create flows for an API, or you can use an option to import a flow. I'm going to create an event-driven flow in this demo, and in a separate video, I'll show how to create flows for an API. So I'll give the flow a name, I'll call it demo git and Slack. So I'm going to drive the flow using a scheduler node. It's an easy way to start the flow. And I'll just change the option to run every hour, but there's an option to start when the flow is first switched on. So I'll select that option as well. So that's the first node configured. I'm now going to add a GitHub node. So there are many different nodes that you can choose from. They're all listed here. I am going to search for my GitHub node by typing GitHub, and it has been shown below here. And I'm going to select the action to retrieve issues. So let me show you my GitHub repo. I have a GitHub repo here, which has a number of issues that have been created in the repo, but a subset of them have a label of bug. I type label colon bug in the filter. You can see that four issues have a label of bug. So I'll be retrieving these four issues and then sending a Slack message for each of these issues. Let me connect to GitHub. I'm going to select GitHub Cloud. And for GitHub Cloud, I need to provide an access token. So full instructions on how to access various SaaS endpoints are available in the IBM documentation. I've provided the access token and I will click on connect. It has connected and now I will select the organization and the repo. And I'll add a condition to say that I want issues with a label of bug. And I'm going to select the option to process 10 items from the collection. Okay, so that's my node configured. Now I can test that this node has been properly configured by clicking on test action. And I receive a result of 200 OK. I can click on view details if I want to see specific details about what's been returned. And now I'm confident that that node has been configured correctly. So this will return four issues. So now I need to add a for each node so that I can loop through each issue that's found and then send a Slack message. So I'm going to click on this plus sign to add another node and select the for each node so that I can loop around the issues. So I'm going to select the issues that are returned. So I click on this button here, which allows me to select the mappings to use. So under GitHub retrieve issues, I'm going to select issue. And that's going to return an array of issues. Okay, so the for each node will iterate around each of the issues that is returned. So inside the for each loop, I'm going to add a Slack node. So if I remove GitHub and now search for Slack, Slack is now shown, and I'm going to select the option to send a message to Slack channel. So I'll click on connect, and now I have to specify the access token for Slack. So I have an access token to use for my Slack organization. I'm going to select the channel as the destination type and send it to a channel called demo the new node in ACE. And now I'm going to specify the text to use. So I will type this issue has a label of bug. And now I can click on this button to insert a mapping. I'm going to loop through the results from the for each node. So I'm going to select issue number. And then I'm going to separate it with a colon and now select another mapping from the for each node, and I'll select the title. And that is my Slack node configured. I can check if it is working. And that is working. It sent a test message to my Slack channel. So here you go, it sent a sample using sample data. So now I'm confident that I have configured the Slack message correctly. Okay. So now I am ready to test the flow. So I'll select test flow and using real data this time. And now it is sending messages to Slack. So it has retrieved the four issues from GitHub. And for each of the issue that was found, it has sent a message to Slack. So as you can see, I have very quickly created a flow. I was able to test each node individually. I was able to start the flow, and I didn't have to configure any integration server or any policy or credentials. It's all done behind the covers. So the policies and credentials are defined automatically and they are saved, and you are now able to, if you like, export the flow YAML and use it elsewhere. So I have very quickly created a flow which allows me to retrieve issues from GitHub, and for each of the issues that were found, I was able to send a message to Slack. So this demonstrates how quickly you can create simple flows using Designer.